Hello friends, today we will see how a tennis tournament problem can be solved using the divide and conquer strategy. What is meant by a tennis tournament problem? That is, if I have many players who are participating in the tennis tournament, then we are supposed to develop a strategic approach so that we can find out which player will be playing with other player, and if I have selected random n number of players, then we decide that who will play against the other player and what will be the winner strategy. This is just a programming approach which finds out the number of players on the random basis from the list that it has, and then predicts the winner and gives you a list of the total matches played, the winner of those matches, and in the end, the winner of the tournament. That is what it is known as, the tennis tournament problem. Divide and conquer application for this is just a strategic approach to tell that these are the kind of problems from the real world that can be implemented and solved using recursion and divide and conquer. We start with the program. It is a simple C program, so we have the various header files here, that is stdio.h, conio.h, and standard library with the header files. Winner is a name of a function which predicts the winner using the strategy. It takes the array size, the integer variable, and the size on which we are going to find out the winner. We have declared simple variables w1, w2, and mid. As this tennis tournament problem is a strategic approach implementation of divide and conquer, so any divide and conquer problem will always have a variable called mid, because it signifies that I'm going to divide my array list into two parts by finding the middle of the array. So, and W1 and W2 taken as two variable names which will tell the two winners from each team. If I have 8, then there will be various winners. So how do I depict the winners? So we've taken it as a name of W1 and W2. If n minus x is greater than 2, then we continue in the loop. That is, there are more than 2 players, so we can find out that who is the winner, and this function can be randomly worked on and it can be implemented using divide and conquer strategy. We find out the mid by using the simple mid function, x plus n by 2, the first element, the last element by 2. W1 is equal to winner px mid. So whatever is the value of my mid, it is recursively passed over here to the winner, and the first winner is calculated, or it is predicted from this particular working module. Again, the second winner has to be predicted, because if there are more than 2 players, I cannot decide directly who is the winner. So depending on the number of players in my list, or the number of players that have enrolled for this tournament, that is when I enter the number of players, it will be divided into the qualifying round, the quarterfinals, semifinals, and the finals. So for every league, or from every array that I subdivide my list into, I'll be having winners from each list. That is why I need two winners, W1 and W2. It follows the normal divide and conquer strategy. So I have mid, and I have mid plus 1. Now what happens if W1 is less than W2, that is, if he has won or lost the match, depending on the number, then we say the winner between the two is W1, W2, and the winner is W2, and we return W2. If W2 has won, then we return W2. Else what happens? Else we say the winner between the two players' name. If I have player 1 and 2, then I say the winner between player 1 and 2 is player won, that is if W1 has won. Otherwise, the winner between 1 and 2, if two players were there and W1 was less than W2, then W2 has won the match. Here, this particular loop closes. Now starts my main program, from where I have called this particular function of winner. Here is a simple program which says, again, the main function int I, which is a loop variable. Win is a name of a simple winner. N is the player that I need to enter, and P is an array which can hold the name and the ranking of 100 players. Enter the number of players, that is, I need to enter that in this particular tennis tournament, how many players are going to play, and that I'm going to scan with a variable N. After I have scanned, I vary my loop from 0 to less than N. And then I increment, and now how do I choose my players? I choose my player by using the random function. That is why we have used in the beginning an std lib file. Rand is a function which works on it. Random function will generate the random numbers of players that are going to play. Since here are 8 players, so 8 random numbers will be generated, which are going to have a match between each, and then the result will be declared. Winner will be saved in win. That is, what will win do? Whatever is the function win is returning, winner is returning, that is, whether it was returned W2 or returned W1 that we have seen, that will be saved in the variable win. And then the winner is win value will be printed. How does the result work on? Let's see. This was the programming code. How, when I actually execute this code, how does it actually work? Enter the number of players. I have entered it as 8. These are the random players which are generated. I have P of 100. So any number between 1 to 100 random numbers will be generated. So player 1 to player 8, I have this particular list. Here it is with the numbers. So when I do it with the numbers, randomly they will be judged, and I'll have the winner between 38 and 46 is 46. Between 20 and 55, the winner is 20. And between 46 and 20, again, the winner is 20. Now, how does 46 and 20 come into picture? That is, winner between 38 and 46 is 46. So that becomes W1. Winner between 20 and 55 is 20. So for the next session or the next match, 46 and 20 play. So 20 becomes the first one. Then the winner between 53 and 55 is 55. The winner between 46 and 12 is 46. So here are the two winners, 55 and 46. So between 55 and 46, the winner is 55, and the winner between 20 and 55 is 20, and the final winner is 20. So this is how my continuous loop will be working. So what happens is, the winner is in the end taken and declared. Thank you.